say, the Mandindane, the tormentors, the torturers, as they are called amongst my people, are the servants of the Chitawuli, the beasts of the Silo Sengubo, the beasts of the terrible blanket. They are all one and the same race. The Mandindane have no genitals. In other words, they are drones for the Chitawuli, who are capable of reproducing. The Mandindane find medicine, so our great teachers tell us, for the Chitawuli to keep them alive. For example, say, the kidnapping of people goes back hundreds of years amongst my people. Zulu warriors, when they went to battle, used to wear a very strange object on the tips of the organs of manhood, say, a grass cap. This grass cap was not worn for modesty or for protecting the genital. It was worn because when warriors were an army moving through the bush to attack a faraway tribe, they were followed and some of them were kidnapped and drained of semen by the Mandindane. Now, this grass cap used to endanger the Zulu warrior's life because sometimes when the battle really got hot, the grass cap got between the warrior, came off the tip of the warrior's penis, and it got between his thighs, causing him to fall down and get killed. But they had to wear this thing, which are many of which are still being made by craftsmen today, in order to protect themselves from the Mandindane. My mother was kidnapped in 1918, some years before I was born. And then she was kidnapped again with me as a baby. And she could not account for the several hours of time she had lost. And her father beat her up thinking that she was a liar.
He beat her up thinking she was a liar.
My grandfather beat her up thinking that she had gone to meet her boyfriend, but she had disappeared with me on her back, according to some old women who later told me the story. And she reappeared a few hours later, not knowing where she had been. Now, this phenomenon, sir, is very, very common in Africa and South Africa, and nobody has ever bothered to really research it. And one thing, sir, is this. We human beings must accept that we are not alone in this world. The proof that there were other great civilizations before us is overwhelming. Here in South Africa, for example, a huge rock was cut up by machines, a rock many millions of years old. The scientists wanted to use that stone to line the insides of the jet pipes of guided missiles. And inside this stone, which is called pyrophyllin, were found incredible spheres made of metal about the size of a golf ball.
I've seen pictures of them, Credo. They're round, perfectly round spheres, and they have grooves cut along the equator, two, three, four grooves, perfectly around these metal spheres.
Yes, sir. And what happens if you put one of those metal spheres on a table, sir, and watch it for several hours? It rotates in sympathy with the Earth. You can see it actually rotating without a power source, without a source of energy. This must have been technology many, many millions of years ahead of our time.
I was told that those were found in rock that was in excess of 1 billion years old.
Yes, sir. These things are made by intelligent entities. And anyone who doubts that we are who says that we are the first civilization on this planet, sir, is mad. And the sooner we look into this phenomenon, like human, like thinking people, the better for our own survival. Say, let me tell you one thing, and share this with your listeners, please. And also with Mr. David Icke. Is he there?
Yeah, I'm here, Cairo, yeah.
Say, will you please tell the honorable presenter, say, what did I show you which was found? Do you remember the X-ray I showed you?
Right, yeah.
Of Cecilia's womb.
Mm-hmm.
Of the strange artifact which was found inside her womb. This artifact killed Cecilia. I should really not be talking so in public, but I'm dedicating this talk to my departed wife. Cecilia was not killed by the cancer that she was suffering from. She died very suddenly. Her blood pressure dropped exactly 3 weeks after I received a death threat threatening her. Say, the Chitauli or the conspirators, or call them what you will, are active now, and they are interfering even with our private lives. I can tell you things that will shake you, but for which there are witnesses, how I myself am being destabilized even now.
David Icke?
By men, sir?
I was going to ask David to comment. Go ahead, Grado, finish.
Sir, today in South Africa, there are so-called security firms,
mm-hmm.
which somehow are connected to bigger security firms in England and elsewhere. These firms supply bodyguards for important people, and some of these bodyguards I was given over to them that they should look after my affairs, to look after my money and so on.
Mm-hmm.
But they started interfering with my personal life. They started chasing away wise men and women whom I had gathered around me for many years in order to make a group of wise people which would help our people in South Africa. And also everything that I try to do, everything that I try to create is subtly destroyed by these men. Mercenaries interfering with human lives in South Africa, even as we are talking, say, I have a plan to save the rhinos from extinction by offering the Chinese who buy rhino horn as an aphrodisiac dehydrated ostrich eggs, which is a true aphrodisiac. But my plan has been frustrated by some of these men.
Hmm.
And, you know, sir, if people doubt that there is a conspiracy, let them tell me, why is Africa being murdered and by whom? If there are no Chitauli, why are there senseless wars ravaging my country? If there are no reptilians, why are we seeing men and women on this planet who seem to be virtually immortal? Should I mention a name?
Go ahead, just for fun.
Say, there are men on this earth who appear to be deathless.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Henry Kissinger is one.
I was going to say, there's certainly some men who seem to be very healthy in their latter years, and Henry Kissinger is certainly one of them, no doubt. David, we
Mr.
have...
Mr. George Bush is another.
Yeah, he looks great. They both do. They're getting some kind of special treatment, or...
You know, sir, we human beings must think very deeply now. We claim to be masters of our own destiny. We are not. We claim to be in charge of our path in life. We are not.